Welcome to the Ballet African.
Your name?
My name is Dalili Pearson.
Yes.
I saw Le Ballet African de Guinée in Los Angeles in 1963.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the first time I had ever seen them. And when they performed without covering their breasts.
Looks good.
Have you seen it?
You know, what I've been to tell you? You know, back then when they first came, the women used to dance bare-breasted. The first show?
And it was very natural, it was very beautiful, and quite exciting, except the Los Angeles community, and I should say the powers that be, complained, and they closed down the ballet when they came here in 1963.
Sika mentioned the same thing.
And then what happened was, the people complained so much, the community came out and raised literal hell. And what happened was somebody came up with a brilliant idea and got some bras to cover them, and they came back on and performed again.
Wow.
Then
good
I had, yeah. Then I had a chance to see them again in Paris in 1964.
Wow.
And when I saw them, you know, for the first time, they changed my life. And in that Parisian performance in 64, I got to meet a whole lot of other Guineans that were in Paris at the time.
Yeah.
And really, this performance changed my life. I ended up getting a master's in African area studies, focusing on African writers and French expression. And I've been following the Negritude movement in my studies. So coming here is like a full circle. I believe it's very important for us to come out and support and respect a country that has chosen the best singers that they have and brought them together with the best dancers they have, with the best musicians and drummers they have. And it's quite a very wonderful experience. And we as a black community have a special connection to the country of Guinea, because that's where Stokely Carmichael resided for about the last 25 years of his life with Mary Makeba.
Exactly.
And they lived in the palace of Sékou Touré. And we also should be respecting this company because the president, Sékou Touré, is one of the primary leaders of Pan-African political structure and culture. And he even did something that has never happened anywhere in the world. When the people got tired of Kwame Nkrumah, who had politicized to a point where the people didn't like him anymore, Sékou Touré, the president of Guinea, invited him to come and share his presidency with him in his country. And so he lived in Guinea at the last days of his life.
Wow. Thank you.
Beautiful.
Excellent. And this is the other one.
These are the 50-year Golden Jubilee shows, 50 years of our history.
Oh, fantastic.
Playbills all the way back from 1953 forward.
Yes, it's beautiful.
It is a nice poster.
Yeah, who designed that?
Well, a few of us had our hands in it.
That's very nice.
Not going to take all the credit, but we're really happy with it.
You did a very good job.
I got one of these.
Oh, yeah. You have one?
Oh, okay.
I got one before I got that one.
Okay.
Oh, that's beautiful.
I have the white one, too.
Right, Chief. The Emperor. We know whose heads are gonna roll. We know some heads are gonna roll.
The warriors in the desert.
Yeah.
All right, Tonic.
Hey, you need the turban though. You need the turban.
Yeah, I'm
like
right.
Thank you. exotic goddess.
Is a picture or is a camera? Is a video?
Video.
Oh, okay.
How you doing?
I'm doing good.
What's your name?
Ali.
Ali, you're here in front of Sika's?
Yeah.
With very beautiful clothes. Are you going to the African Ballet tonight?
Tonight, yeah, to check those Guinean people.
Yes.
Yeah, I will check them.
Here too.
Yeah.
So it should be a wonderful show.
Oh, yeah, they play good.
Yes, they do.
That is a natural. It's not joke about that.
No, it isn't.
Yeah, that is a natural one.
Thank you, and I'll see you tonight.
All right, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Did you enjoy it?